Okay, so I was not expecting this. I just opened up Steam 10 minutes ago to find out that Valve is making a portable PC and is now really getting back into hardware after the whole we're gonna turn your PC into a console thing a couple years ago, and now, you know, it looks like that they're finally giving it another try. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, if you go onto Steam right now, you should see like a little banner thing that says Steam Deck, and it shows off what is Valve's new console, or next console, I guess, or first console, depends on how you look at it. As you may know, or maybe you don't know, Valve tried to make consoles sort of before, where they had like these Steam consoles where you could like play in big picture mode and they would run Linux and all that. And it was supposed to be a competitor to regular consoles, but it wasn't in the slightest, and it failed miserably. But I guess Valve never gave up on hardware completely. They've been phasing out some stuff. They brought the Valve Index into the picture, but now I guess they're really going in with the Steam Deck. So this is something that was unexpected. I didn't hear any rumors about it. Maybe I just wasn't paying attention, but this is something I hadn't really heard much about. I've heard the name Steam Deck floating around before, but I've never actually heard of this as a real product that's being developed. But if you don't know what this thing is, it is basically kind of like a Nintendo Switch in terms of what it's supposed to do. As in, you can play your entire Steam library wherever you go. Now, if you look at the design of it, I have IGN footage playing in the background because I just switched to Windows 11 and I can't seem to get things working right now, so I can't really get gameplay. But if you look at it, it's very different though from what a Nintendo Switch looks like. It also looks a little bit uncomfortable and unconventional, but I mean, that is kind of how a lot of Valve's products have been. If you ever use a Steam controller or at least seen one, it definitely looks like it look that thing looked weird, but when you used it, you eventually got used to it. I have one. And it's a good controller. I really like it. You can't get them anymore because Valve, I thought they were done with hardware, but I guess not. I guess this is the future. Now, in terms of the specs and pricing, release date, and all that, Valve basically gave out everything, but almost everything. So there's gonna be three versions that are all gonna have different. They're all gonna be the exact same in terms of processing power, which I'll get into in a minute. The versions will start from 500 Canadian to 660 Canadian to 820 Canadian, which I'm assuming is probably gonna be about 400 US, then maybe like 550 US, and then maybe like 750 US around there, maybe 699 between them. So maybe at the max you'll be paying about 699, 750 for versions that have 64 gigabytes, 256 gigabytes, and 512 gigabytes of storage, which the latter two will have NVMe SSD storage. First two will have eMMC. Essentially, the first one is going to be like your regular Nintendo Switch OLED in terms of its storage, which is not much at all. I mean, 64 gigabytes is, to put it lightly, that's anemic for 2020. But I guess at the very least, they do have a version that goes up to 512 gigabytes of fast storage. Also, something I forgot to mention. The battery life on this thing is pretty good. 7 to 8 hours is what they advertise. So that's a pretty narrow range, but it's definitely better than what the Nintendo Switch is pumping out, at least for the most part. The Switch's range is like unbelievable. It's like 9.5 at the max, I believe, and 4.5 at the minimum for the newer model. So it's not like it's technically not as good as a Nintendo Switch battery, but it's still better most of the time. It's weird, but it's still a decent battery, and especially when you consider that most of the games you're gonna be playing on here are pretty gonna be pretty large games. At least I assume that's probably what I'd be using it for. That's not bad. The 256 gigabyte model will have faster storage, of course, because it's an NVMe, a carrying case, and an exclusive Steam community. I can't fucking speak right now. Profile bundle. That might be kind of cool. That seems to be the new thing right now, is spending Steam points on pimping out your profile. The more expensive $699, whatever price it'll be, that's 512 gigabytes, will have a premium anti-glare etched glass. So I don't know why that wouldn't be on the other ones unless it's just a screen protector. An exclusive carrying case, an exclusive Steam profile, maybe it's different, and an exclusive virtual keyboard theme, whatever that is. I guess you can have a custom theme for your fucking keyboard now on this little stupid ass device that you can carry. If I saw someone using this in public, I don't know how I'd feel. It's very unconventional looking. Now, when you look internally, there is some other stuff too. It has 16 gigabytes of RAM, which is way better than the Switch, which I believe has four or six, one of the two. It has a AMD APU. So it sounds like, looking through this, because it's got a Zen 2 as its CPU, and for the GPU, it's got RDNA cores, RDNA 2, sorry. It seems like that what this is about, like, it's not as powerful as, of course, like a Series X or a PS5, because it also only has 1.6 teraflops, which is not a lot. Like, that's not super, that's not like a, I know teraflops aren't everything, but when you compare to the Series X, which has 12, or the PS5, which has like 11, and even the Series S, which has 4, it's not a ton. That's less than the base PS4, and that's around what, a little bit less from what I can remember of the Xbox One S. Which they need, their fucking naming is awful, but so it's not like super powerful, but for a portable device, which I'm gonna take out the Smok Z, if you remember that, because that thing is fucking dead and it was a scam. I guess now it's the most powerful mobile device that's available to consumers in terms of playing, for just playing games. At least as far as I know, there might be some weird Chinese product that, you know, steals your data and you'll get arrested and probably sentenced to death for, you know, maybe posting the wrong thing on your WeChat profile. But this, I can probably say, is the most, going to be the most commonly available, most powerful mobile device. So that'll usurp the role of a Nintendo Switch. Obviously, the Nintendo Switch is still going to be something people buy, but in terms of being the most powerful device you can get, it's not going to be the Switch anymore. Which, again, that's not really much of an accomplishment, because the Switch is not very powerful to begin with. In terms of the display, it's 16x10 with a resolution of 1280x800, so slightly better than the Nintendo Switch by like 80 pixels. Now, something I also forgot to mention that I'm just recording from the future is that there's also going to be a dock included with the Steam Deck. So if the comparisons start to run wild with the Nintendo Switch and the Steam Deck, that's why. It's not going to be included, it's sold separately, and not, basically no information is available besides that. But there will be a dock, and that, it, when you look at this whole thing, it, to put it lightly, there may have been some inspiration from the Nintendo Switch. It's an LCD screen, so it's not going to have what the Switch OLED has, or even the PS Vita has, but that's okay. I'm okay with not having OLED, because if the price is going to be lower for that. The screen is 7 inches, also like the Switch. 400 nits, so it does get quite bright, and the refresh rate is only 60 hertz, which is not surprising. Now, in terms of software, this is probably something that's going to be a little bit worrying to some people, or at least may give them flashbacks to what happened with the previous Steam OS consoles. The operating system is going to be an Arch Linux-based SteamOS 3.0. This is Linux, and that's not surprising, but it is a little bit, it would be a little bit worrying if you weren't too familiar with what Valve has been doing recently, which, now thinking about it, was probably setting the stage for this thing, because what Valve has been working on, I believe, is called Proton. Now, when the previous SteamOS big picture, whatever you want to call it, was available in those Steam console things, Linux was a quite different of a platform, because it didn't have a lot of the gaming optimizations that even Valve has contributed to now. Because what I'm assuming the whole, what's going to make this thing possible, like to actually be a playable experience, because they claim every single Steam game should be runnable on this, which we'll have to see. Valve's translation technology for Windows games to run on Linux is called Proton, and it's apparently really good. I haven't experienced it myself. I've been wanting to try Linux recently, but I fried a USB recently, so I can't really do it. But I've been wanting to try out Proton because I've heard really good things about it, and I hate how Microsoft just will just take data and send it to some random, who knows where it's being sent, probably aliens. But this is definitely a big deal, because now, in comparison to 2014, 2015, when Valve tried this before, you can now hopefully, have a good experience playing Windows-based games that can't natively run on Linux on your Linux-based Steam Deck using this Proton translation technology. And I know Wine is also available too. I don't know whether Wine is as good as Proton or whether you can use them in conjunction. I'm not too familiar with Linux, so you gotta give me a bit of slack there. But yeah, that is the Steam Deck's tech specs. Now, if you're thinking about buying one of these, and I am, to be honest, because it looks interesting. I know I say that about a lot of things. It looks potentially really good. You do have to be a bit wary about how Valve is going to sell this. So because of everything going on with the pandemic and the fact that it's very hard to get any tech product right now, basically, if you've ever tried getting a graphics card in the past couple months, you will have found that it's basically impossible. If you tried getting a PlayStation 5 or a Series X or S, you have also found that's probably basically impossible depending on where you live. So Valve knows this, and what I think that they're doing is, the reason for this is they're not going to be directly selling it just yet. What you're going to be doing is you're going to have to pay like a small fee, about $5, to reserve it. So pre-ordering it, basically, but kind of pre-ordering it. You're only like you're paying for the ability to pre-order it, and you'll be able to do this tomorrow on the 16th. And I don't know if it's gonna sell it really quickly. I'm imagining it probably will. We're gonna have to see what people will do with this, whether it just flies off shelves or whether it'll just sit there. I'm gonna imagine that pre-orders for this thing they're probably not in huge numbers, so they're probably just going to fly off shelves. But that's just based on how people are right now with technology. That's just my anecdotal perspective. So should you buy a Steam Deck? I don't fucking know. It's up to you. I mean, really, with how Valve is marketing this, if you liked your experience with a Nintendo Switch, you may like this. You'll have to see. I'm assuming that it's not going to be an amazing experience out of the gate. It could be, just because this is Valve's first time going into the mobile market like this, so it may not be perfect in December when this thing launches. December 2021, I think I forgot to mention that. We'll have to see how this is. I think I may do a I'm not gonna hold my breath there. I don't know if I'm gonna actually do a review. I might, maybe, I'll get this, maybe. I've been recently wanting to save money, so I don't know whether I'd do this. I would definitely only get the $500 version if I were to. And we'll have to see whether it's any good to begin with. But it's definitely an interesting concept, being able to play Steam games wherever you are. This is basically the Smox Z, but actually done by a company that hopefully knows what it's doing. So I trust Valve to make a good product, but I'm also a little bit worried that this may not be perfect when it comes out, but we'll have to see. Again, who knows how this will go. So that is the Steam Deck. If you want to learn more, if you go onto Steam, there's a whole like website that they have built in that basically just advertises it to you. Hopefully this is going to be something that that is good, and then it'll issue in a new age for playing Steam games mobile, and we won't need to worry about the Smox Z anymore. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to subscribe and like and do everything that every other YouTuber has told you to do. I will see you later. I am going to finish fixing up my computer. So, thank you guys and see ya.